This video will look at several different parts of using the microscope. The first step is to place the slide on the stage. And once you have the slide on the stage, it becomes necessary to be able to center the slide so that you can view. There are two knobs on the side of the stage. In this particular microscope, they are oriented up and down. On some microscopes, they can be horizontally, and these two knobs control movement of the stage in the right to left and back and forth. If you take the knobs and you move them, you will see that the stage moves right to left, and the other knob will move it back and forth. You use these knobs to center your material so that you can observe it. Because if you try and move the stage with your hand, what will happen is you will not be able to get the fine control that you can get out of these particular knobs. The next set of controls we look at are on the side of the base of the microscope, on the support, and these are the coarse and fine focusing adjustments. What these do is these move the stage closer and farther away from the objective. When you have your slide in place, you want to place the slide as far up as you possibly can. Don't be afraid of hitting the objective, because most of these objectives are spring-loaded, and when you start on the lowest objective, you will get nowhere near hitting it. You use the coarse focusing knob to get it into a coarse focus, and the fine focusing knob to get it into fine focus. The coarse focusing knob is the outer knob. The fine focusing knob is the inner knob. When you turn these, do not turn them quickly, but rather turn them slowly so that you can actually see where you're going. If you turn them too quickly, many times you jump past what you really want to look at. When we put all of these parts together, we put the slide on the stage. We take the stage, we place the stage as far up as we possibly can. We have our 4x objective. We center the specimen under the 4x objective, and then we focus using the coarse focusing knob to push the material as far forward, as far up as possible, and then the fine focusing knob to bring it into focus. And you can see how in this particular case we now have this in focus. We then grab the turret, we rotate the turret to bring in the next higher power objective, which in this case is the 10x objective. We click it into place. You should not have to move the specimen much at this point. It may take a little bit of movement to make sure that it's centered. You then take your fine focusing knob, and again, as we look through this, we can focus this in and get this focused. Once we have it focused, we want to make sure that our stage is centered, our material is centered. We go out, we grab the turret, we rotate and bring the high dry objective, which is the 40x objective, in. We focus using the fine focusing knob. And here you can see us bringing it into focus. We then go and make sure we've got everything centered. Now, when we go in between the 40x and the 100x objective, we need to add oil onto the slide in order to be able to visualize this properly. We turn the turret so that the 40X and the oil objective are separated over the slide. We then take our immersion oil. We place a drop of the immersion oil in the center of the slide. You can see the little glass dropper coming in. Rotating up, you place a drop of the material in the center of the slide. You then rotate the oil immersion objective into the oil. You will see that the oil will actually touch the objective. And once it has touched the objective, only use the fine focusing knob. Now be very careful and do this only very slowly because you can go past this very quickly. You slowly bring this into focus. And as you do that, you can now observe the material under the microscope. So using the microscope is an integral part of microbiology. It just takes a little practice to be able to do this correctly. But once you learn how to do it, you can use any microscope out there, and they all work virtually in the same manner.